Hello everyone, I welcome you all on this YouTube channel, the UPSC TV by RS, and here I'm back with yet another video, yet another article with respect to the Hindu newspaper. And as you know that we are covering the Hindu for your UPSC CSE public administration optional. So aapko pata hai ki the Hindu ka jo edition hai, the Hindu ka newspaper hai, uska jo public administration optional ka dimension hai, public administration optional ke jo relevant आर्टिकल्स हैं वो हम इस पर्टिकुलर सीरीज में डिस्कशन कर रहे हैं उनके ऊपर. और आज जो होने जा रहा है वो होने जा रहा है लेक्चर नंबर नेक्स्ट, ओके, 1 जुलाई 2020 की बात करेंगे. टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट 1 जुलाई 2020. सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड एंड लेट्स ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज आर्टिकल्स एंड लेट्स लिंक दोज आर्टिकल्स विद योर पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन करंट अफेयर्स दैट यू कैन यूज इन योर पेपर वन एज एग्जाम्पल एंड पेपर टू एज द यू कैन से सेग्रीगेटेड टॉपिक इटसेल्फ. ठीक है, तो आप क्या कर सकते हैं, इन आर्टिकल्स का अपना एक नोट्स बना सकते हैं. एंड अगर नोट्स आपको बने हुए चाहिए, यू कैन जॉइन द टेलीग्राम चैनल पबेट पीडिया ऑफिशियल. पबेट पीडिया इज़ अ काइंड ऑफ विकीपीडिया ऑफ पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन विच इज़ रन बाय मी ओनली. सो आप टेलीग्राम पर ज्वाइन कर लीजिए एंड वहाँ पर आपको पीडीएफ वगैरह और जो इन्फॉर्मेशन है वो मिलती रहती है विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. पबेट ऑप्शनल के लिए सबसे बड़ा जो टेलीग्राम पर कोई ग्रुप है तो वो यही है जिसका मैं नाम बता रहा हूँ, लिंक डिस्क्रिप्शन में है. शुरू करते हैं आज की कार्यवाही. तो शुरू करने से पहले यहाँ पर ये जो आर्टिकल हैं वो हम यहाँ पर डिस्कशन में लेंगे. तो देखते हैं कौन से वो आर्टिकल हैं जो पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑप्शनल के लिए रेलिवेंट रहेंगे 1 जुलाई 2020 को. ओके, सो लेट्स स्क्रॉल डाउन एंड हेयर द फर्स्ट थिंग फर्स्ट, फ्री फूड ग्रेन्स स्कीम टिल नवंबर. ओके, सो दिस आर्टिकल इज़ ऑल अबाउट रूरल डेवलपमेंट. यू हैव टू बी थॉरो विद द स्कीम्स लाइक प्रधानमंत्री गरीब कल्याण अन्न योजना एंड अदर रेलिवेंट स्कीम्स लाइक फूड नेशनल फूड सिक्योरिटी एक्ट एंड अदर स्कीम्स लाइक TPDS, IPDS. सो प्लीज़ ट्राई टू रीड दीज थिंग्स. दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट टास्क दैट यू हैव टू डू. दिस इज़ द होमवर्क फॉर यू एज वेल. यू हैव टू गो थ्रू द निटिग्रिटीज ऑफ दीज स्कीम्स इट्सेल्फ. ओके, सो आई एम नॉट हेयर टू एक्सप्लेन द थिंग्स बट स्टिल दिस इज़ समथिंग दैट इज़ वेरी ईजी टू डू. दैट्स वाई आई एम नॉट डूइंग दिस थिंग. अदर थिंग्स वेयर एनालिसिस इज देयर आई विल कवर दीज थिंग्स डेफिनेटली. जहाँ पर एनालिसिस है वो तो मैं कवर करूँगा ही. सो लेट्स मूव टू द प्लेस वेयर वी हैव टू कवर द फर्स्ट आर्टिकल. तो पहला आर्टिकल जो है वो कहाँ है तो ये रहा वो आर्टिकल. वॉट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, वॉट यू हैव टू रीड इन टूडेज आर्टिकल, टूडेज द हिंदू इज दिस, यूटिलाइज MGNREGA टू द फुलेस्ट कैपेसिटी. ओके, सो हेयर बेसिकली वॉट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड इज द टॉपिक कॉल्ड मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट एंड अदर थिंग्स. ओके, सो लेट मी ब्रिंग द थिंग्स. ओके, so now what you have to understand that this particular article is relevant to your rural development. As I have already told you that aapko Pradhan Mantri garib kalyan ann yojana ye sab padhna hai, so that thing is there, so you can read those salient features and all. So here what this article is talking about, this article is relevant for rural development. So now what government is doing apart from MGNREGS, okay, let me give you the perspective of this scheme because this is not that much in news. So MGNREGA, MG Narega is there, and apart from that government has launched a new scheme which is with respect to Garib Kalyan Rojgar Abhiyan. As you can see over here, Garib Kalyan Rojgar Abhiyan. So in this scheme is different from MGNREGA, and the writer is talking about the you can say problems and issues with this particular scheme. The first of all, you have to be thorough with the differences. आपको पता होना चाहिए that what all are the differences between MGNREGA and this Pradhan Mantri, this Garib Kalyan Rojgar Abhiyan. So here MGNREGA is something where right to work is a legal right. यहाँ पे जो राइट टू वर्क है वो एक लीगल राइट हुआ करता था, बट यहाँ ऐसा नहीं है. जो अभी जो योजना आई है ये लीगल राइट ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, नो लीगल राइट. इसके अलावा MGNREGA द ओल्ड वन, हेयर यू विल गेट 100 days ऑफ वर्क, ओके, इन गारंटीड वर्क एंड दिस इज देयर. बट इन दिस स्कीम दिस इज अबाउट 125 days ऑफ वर्क. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट द प्रीवियस MGNREGA इट वॉज अ काइंड ऑफ स्कीम दैट विल वर्क थ्रू आउट द ईयर. ओके, So this was the scenario, but this scheme is a kind of one-time scheme amid COVID-19. So you can use this thing in the situational leadership as well, okay, that for the time being these kind of things are there, sunset clause sort of thing you can say. And apart from that, what you have to understand that MGNREGA comes under Ministry of Rural Development, but this Garib Kalyan Ann Rozgar Yojana, this schemes does not come under the idea MORD, but it is the combination of 12 ministries, departments and all, okay. So yahan pe aisa hai. And apart from that, the major difference, another major difference is the fact that this MGNREGS, here you will get unemployment allowance, okay, unemployment allowance you will get whenever you will not get the work, okay. So agar 100 days ka work likha hua hai, agar aapko nahi mil raha, to you will get the unemployment allowance, lekin yahan aisa nahi hai, yahan sirf work hai. And apart from that, yesterday only on 30th June itself, Prime Minister was talking about this thing that June month is coming, monsoon is coming, and now agriculture will face, you can say agricultural work will, you can say, will see the kind of rise. On the other hand, other sectors will witness the slowdown or something like that, because in monsoon the construction will stop and other things will stop. So here also you can understand that MGNREGA becomes more important, because here other kind of rojgar and unemployment will suffer. So aur baki to waise hi suffer honge. So you can understand that unemployment allowance becomes more important. So that's why writer is talking about some issues. The first issue is, pehla issue hai, that yahan par jo 116 selected district mein ye scheme chalegi, throughout India nahi chalegi. So this is another difference between MGNREGA and this. So here the writer is saying that what is the criteria of selecting these 116 selected district, okay. So this is not the kind of aspirational district program where Niti Aayog is doing the things, okay, or some criteria is not there. So here the writer is giving the example that if you look at the data, you will get that Bihar is getting more priority. So the writer is linking this thing with the election. Writer keh rahe hain ki yaar election aane wala hai, to Bihar mein jo 116 डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैं उसमें बिहार के ज़्यादा कवर कर लिए जाएंगे ताकि लोग खुश रहें, वोट करें, ओके. सो दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट इशू. सो यू कैन टॉक अबाउट द एरिया वाइज पर्सपेक्टिव एज वेल. द सेकेंड इशू इज़ व्हाट इज़ द स्किल मैपिंग रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द, सिंस द वर्क इज़ ऑलरेडी कवर्ड अंडर MGNREGA. सो दिस इज़ अनदर इशू. द अनदर इशू द राइटर इज़ टॉकिंग अबाउट हेयर इज़ with respect to unemployment allowance. As I have already told you, okay, unemployment is time per or sector, jab susti aayegi, jo Modi ji bole the ki susti aayegi baaki sectors mein, to jab susti aayegi to logon ko unemployment allowance do, hai na. So that thing is also there. So these things are there. And apart from that, way forward, you can use that the need of the hour is to strengthen MGNREGA rather than bringing some parallel, you can say, kind of ideas, okay, because parallel ideas will, you can say, you can understand, you can link this thing with your, you can say, Taylor was talking about classification of work, and he was of the view that there is a law of diminishing coordination, okay. So if you classify something in more components, okay, for example, if you divide a particular task in different components, let me give you the example from second ARC itself. Second ARC says ki jo highway roadway, second ARC says that transport is one sector. Why you are segregating transport into railways, ministry of railways, ministry of roadways, ministry of shipping, okay, why you are doing this, and ministry of civil aviation as well, okay. So writer in second ARC recommended this thing that there is a need to amalgamate these things, okay. So inko jod do yaar, roadway, railway, highway, waterway, shipping, hai na, civil aviation, hai to sab transport hi, to ek hi ministry honi chahiye na. And similarly ministry of jal shakti bhi isi ideology pe bani. So if you try to understand, classification is good, but classification will lead to law of diminishing coordination, theek hai, law of diminishing coordination, law of diminishing control. So you can use these kind of ideas, okay. So I hope you are getting, and this will create problems, because if you link with RICS, Rix was also talking about this thing that development is not about differentiation. Okay, differentiation or diffracted society is good, but you have to integrate them. And when you are bringing more and more schemes, ke chalo yaar MGNREGA bhi thi, and we are now bringing another scheme. Okay, so in a way, what you are doing, you are basically bringing more, you can say, complexities. Okay, and in this way, what is happening that you have to integrate, you have to expand, you have to basically use your resources to integrate the things in order to get development, in order to get better policy implementation. So writer is talking about this thing. You can talk about the things like this. Okay, I hope you are getting this article. So this article is all about rural development. It is all about the kind of, you can say, second ERC linkage that you can do. You can link it with the classification, you can link it with the kind of division of work. Division of work is something that is a kind of, you can say, principle of administration as well. So we have both the sides. Okay, whether we should divide the schemes like this, okay, that okay, one scheme is already there, we are giving more schemes, and three scheme, four scheme, five scheme, okay, or you should amalgamate them. Okay, so there are both the sides. Okay, on one side you can talk about law of division, you can talk about decentralization, you can talk about differentiation, you can talk about these kind of things. On the other hand, when it comes to favor, you can talk about ki haan tod mod ke kaam karna chahiye, because it will bring efficiency, it will bring specialization, it will bring kind of integration and all. So I hope you are getting it. Okay, so both the ways you have to link with the thinkers and their ideologies. Okay, I hope you are getting this. Or mujhe ummeed hai acche se samajh mein aa gaya hoga. So hindi mein thoda bata deta hu ki yahan par issues bataye gaye hain, aur aap isko bahut sare thinkers se link kar sakte hain. Bahut sare pros aur cons dono taraf ke, तोड़ ऐसे बहुत सारी स्कीम लानी चाहिए या नहीं लानी चाहिए, तो दोनों तरफ की आप बातें कर सकते हैं अलग अलग थिंकर्स के साथ. तो ये आपको यहाँ पर पता होना चाहिए. सेकेंड एआरसी का डायमेंशन बता दिया. सेकेंड एआरसी ने ये चीज़ें बोली हैं अपनी ऑर्गेनाइजेशनल जो रीस्ट्रक्चरिंग की रिपोर्ट है उसमें, 13th रिपोर्ट है आई थिंक. तो वहाँ पर ये चीज़ें एक्सप्लिसिटली सेकेंड एआरसी ने बोली हैं कि ये सब जो दुनिया भर की बना देते हो उसको एक साथ करो, है ना, और उसको लिंक कर सकते हो रिक्स के इंटीग्रेशन और बाकी सारी चीज़ों से. ठीक है, आई होप यू आर गेटिंग ऑल द थिंग्स. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज़ आर्टिकल. द नेक्स्ट न्यूज़ आर्टिकल ये पहले डिलीट करते हैं. लेट मी डिलीट इट फर्स्ट. ओके, सो द नेक्स्ट न्यूज़ आर्टिकल इज़ रिवाइविंग सार्क विद सार्क टू डील विद चाइना. Okay, so this article is here, and what you can do, or now you will ask me that again and again you are bringing international relation into public administration, isn't it? So let me tell you the things what you have to do over here, that reviving SAARC to deal with China. So article is simple, that you have to revive SAARC in order to deal with China, so that these, you can say, salami tactic, there is a kind of tactic of China, salami tactic, in which what they are doing is they are basically influencing our neighboring states like Nepal, like China, not China, China is the game, China is the major player. Like China is doing what? China is basically they are influencing Sri Lanka, they are influencing Bhutan, they are influencing Nepal. Okay, so they are basically creating troubles for India by influencing the regional neighbors of India. Okay, I hope you are getting. So what we have to do, we have to revive SAARC. If we would revive SAARC, what will happen is that hum yahan pe ek coordination bana payenge, we will be able to coordinate. Okay, so now the thing is that how to resolve conflict resolution by, you can say, conflict resolution is not there. What you can do, how can you link, let me bring coordination. So agar SAARC ka revival hoga, if at all there will be the revival of SAARC, what will happen is that there is a kind of linkage with coordination by committees. Who told this thing? This was the idea of Gulick was talking about coordination. He was talking about coordination by committee, coordination by hierarchy, coordination by ideas, isn't it? So he was talking about this thing, and now what we are talking about in this article, revive SAARC. SAARC is what? SAARC is the regional grouping. Grouping is what? It is a kind of committee. You can say it na, aap keh sakte ho na ki SAARC mein ग्रुप है, ग्रुप का मतलब एक कमेटी है, कुछ लोग हैं, एंड व्हेन सम पीपल और सम यू कैन से सम पार्टीज आर देयर, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कमेटी, एंड दिस इज द एग्जांपल ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेशन बाय कमेटी, इजंट इट? किसी को भी डाउट हो ना तो कमेंट में लिख देना कि ऐसे कैसे कर दिया, ओके? और अगर ठीक लगे तो भी लिख देना कि वाह मजा आ गया, है ना? सो समथिंग सॉर्ट ऑफ दिस थिंग. आई होप यू आर गेटिंग दैट दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेशन बाई कमेटीज. नाउ बी इट अ क्वेश्चन, मान लो यूपीएससी में आ जाए कि गूगले, अभी देखो यूपीएससी में एक ट्रेंड चल रहा है, यूपीएससी ने पूछा कि इनका टेलर का रेलिवेंस है, यूपीएससी ने पूछा विल्सन का रेलिवेंस है, कभी पूछा था फॉलेट इज फार अहेड ऑफ आवर टाइम, सो यू कैन प्रूव. हाँ, आज भी अगर उनके आइडियाज़ हैं, सो इट बेसिकली मीन्स कि जब उन्होंने उस टाइम पर बातें की थी तो वो फार अहेड हैं, ओके? इट इज़ बेसिकली प्रूविंग दिस थिंग दैट ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर विद रेस्पेक्ट टू रेलिवेंस. सिमिलरली गूलिक्स रेलिवेंस, इफ एट ऑल देर इज अ क्वेश्चन इन यूपीएससी सीएससी 2020, 2021, 2022, वट एवर, यू कैन यूज दीज थिंग्स दैट चाइना रिवाइवल ऑफ सार्क विल लीड टू डील विद चाइना, दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेशन बाई कमेटी, ओके? यू कैन यूज दिस थिंग एज अ एग्जाम्पल. अदर एग्जाम्पल्स आर यू कैन से जॉइंट कमेटीज एंड अदर थिंग्स, वट एवर द कमेटीज आर देर, यू कैन यूज दीज थिंग्स विद द एग्जाम्पल, ओके? एंड इफ यू यूज दिस रिवाइवल ऑफ सार्क, इट विल गिव यू अ काइंड ऑफ एज, यू कैन यूज दिस एग्जाम्पल, ओके? अदरवाइज देर इज नथिंग कॉल्ड rocket science in it, but still try to link with the current affairs, the things that are going on, in order to show your PubEd knowledge, okay? And apart from that, the another news article that you have to cover is ban apps to get chance to send clarification, whatever. So what you have to remember, let me link this thing with your public administration. Now what you will say, that again you are bringing China, again and again you are bringing China in public administration. So what you have to do is, now let me bring the PubEd idea over here again. Here I will incorporate R factor. What is R factor? Rahul's factor. Let me bring and let me try to analyze this article in a very detailed manner. So what we are doing, hum yahan kya kar rahe hain ki China ke jo app abhi ban hue hain, 59 apps including TikTok, ओके? सो दीज ऐप जो हैं, ये सारे ऐप हैं, ये बैन हो गए, ओके? नाउ द गवर्नमेंट इज सेइंग दैट दीज बैंड ऐप्स विल गेट अ चांस टू सेंड क्लैरिफिकेशन, कि जो जो एलिगेशंस और जो भी गवर्नमेंट कह रही है दैट यहाँ पर ये चीज़ें हो रही थी, तो इसकी वजह से यहाँ पे गवर्नमेंट यहाँ पे एक इनको मौका देगी, बिकॉज इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी एक्ट में एक एक्ट है, इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी के अंदर एक उसमें एक प्रोविजन है दैट यू कैन नॉट बैन लाइक दिस, ओके? तो थोड़ा सा एक क्लैरिफिकेशन, व्हाट इज दिस एंड हाउ कैन यू लिंक दिस थिंग विद योर पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन? सो लेट मी ब्रिंग राहुल फैक्टर ओवर हियर. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ अथॉरिटी, ओके? इफ यू लुक एट द थिंकर्स लाइक बेबर, अगर आप बेबर की बात करो, Beaver was talking about authority, isn't it? So he was talking about authority versus power. If you look at Beaver, Beaver ne baat ki authority ki aur power ki. Power is something, he says that if you have power, you can enforce your will even with the existing resistance. भले ही लोग विरोध करें, फिर भी आप उस विल को एनफोर्स कर पाओगे. तो अगर आप ऐसा कर पा रहे हो, हम कहेंगे कि यस, आपके पास पावर है. दिस वॉज द स्टेटमेंट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू पावर दैट वॉज बींग गिवन बाई बेबर. एंड बेबर वॉज ऑल्सो टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस थिंग. एंड अथॉरिटी इज वॉट? अथॉरिटी इज समथिंग वेयर पीपल विल एक्सेप्ट योर ऑर्डर, बिकॉज योर ऑर्डर, योर पावर हैव द लेजिटिमेसी, ओके? If you are following my courses on Unacademy or on other platforms like Study IAS, wherever I am teaching, I have dealt this thing in a very detailed manner. ठीक है, अगर नहीं पता है तो Beaver by Rahul search कर लेना, you will get this thing. So he was talking about power, he was talking about authority. Power is something that if people are opposing, then also you can enforce, okay? Whatever comes the way, you will enforce the things like dictatorship. But authority is something where you have the legitimacy. And in this, you can say, dimension, he was talking about legitimacy coming from traditional charisma or legal rational. Okay, these are the things that will bring legitimacy, and this will become your power will become authority. This is the thing. So here, what is happening is that here, what we are doing, we are bringing a kind of legal authority is the enforcement, but a kind of you can say that people will accept, okay? How people will accept? When you will bring legitimacy. That's why this all game is going on. Second thing is, you can talk about the ideas of Q cumulative authority. The second R factor is cumulative authority. What is this cumulative authority? अब ये कौन सी बला है? Cumulative authority was the idea given by Follett as well as Mio. Both are talking about cumulative authority. What is this cumulative authority? Cumulative authority means that subordinates should accept your order. Okay. So cumulative authority means subordinates should not resist, subordinates should accept your order, because otherwise you cannot enforce your order and all. Okay, so that's why this is the cumulative authority talking, which was the idea of these thinkers. Okay, I hope you are getting. Apart from that, you can talk about, you can say other model, because in this let's talk about authority in more detailed manner. Okay, authority is something where if you talk about Bernard is also talking about this thing, that authority is a kind of, what do you mean by authority? If you ask from ask to this thinker called Bernard will say, Bernard kahenge that authority is nothing but a tool to enforce, to bring conformity. It is a tool to bring conformity with organizational objective. So organization always have certain objective, and the tool to bring conformity with that objective is called as authority. Okay, so this was the idea of Bernard. Okay, Bernard was also talking about acceptance theory of authority. Okay, isn't it? So you can just bring these dimensions. Okay, and how can you link with this China ban and TikTok ban and whatever? So there is a kind of organization. If you look at government of India, what is the organizational objective of government of India? Here the organizational objective are like, you can say sovereignty of the country, integrity of the country, security of the country. Okay, so authority is a kind of tool to basically bring this conformity with these apps with respect to the organizational objective, or you can say the principles of Indian Republic or whatever. Okay, so these are the minor things. The most important thing is the cumulative authority and the acceptance of authority, which is very important idea that you can bring about. Okay, I hope you are getting this particular article as well, and I hope you are liking this approach as well. And apart from that, what all are the other articles? Is there any more article? Let me, okay, so there is no more article, I guess. Okay, this is all about today's analysis of The Hindu for your public administration optional. I hope this series is helpful for you. Agar series helpful hai, don't forget to like this video, share this video with your friends who have the public administration optional. This is it for the day. Thank you so much, and bye bye.